In the second lecture, we studied the rolling torque and angular momentum. We are going to solve two examples about rolling and angular momentum. This is the first problem. So in this problem, we have an incline. At the top of the incline, we have a uniform ball, mass 6 kilogram, and it has a radius, and we don't know the radius. And the angle is 30 degrees. And we choose x-axis, that direction x, and this is the y-axis. Okay? So the ball, this uniform ball, is rolling without slipping. There is no slipping. It is rolling down on the incline. Why is it rolling? Because of the friction. There is a static friction, and this static friction causes the rolling. So first part of the question, we are going to determine the body's acceleration, center of mass acceleration down the ramp. And the second part of the question, so we are going to determine the magnitude of the frictional force, direction of the frictional force, of course, opposite to the motion. And last part of the question, we are going to determine speed of the ball when it reaches to bottom of the ramp. That distance is h. Okay. So let's start to solve first part of the question. We can apply the Newton's second law to this problem. Net force in x direction, mass time acceleration. What are the net forces? In positive direction, static frictional force, and in negative direction, m times acceleration. And since the ball is rolling and rotating, we have to apply also torque to this equation. So net torque is rotational inertia times angular acceleration. What is the torque? Torque is frictional force times r. They are perpendicular, so therefore sine 90 is 1. So this is the net torque. Static frictional force causes the torque. So this is equal rotational inertia times angular acceleration. And angular acceleration is minus linear acceleration over r. Linear acceleration is negative because it is accelerating in negative x direction. A ball is rotating counterclockwise, so therefore alpha positive. Alpha positive, A negative. So from this equation, frictional force is minus rotational inertia times A over r squared. So we determine frictional force. Now let's insert this equation to that one. This is the frictional force minus mg sine theta equal mass time acceleration. So we can take acceleration and write the equation, acceleration equation in this form. So we can obtain this from that equation. It is easy. Rotational inertia of the ball is 2 over 5 m r square. When we insert here, we get this one. Okay. So as a numerical value, acceleration in x direction is minus 3.5 meter over second square. Okay, it is negative. So once we determine the linear acceleration, from that equation, we can find the static frictional force. And static frictional force equal 8.4 Newton, and it is in positive x direction. So in this equation, all these equations are independent of the radius of the ball. So we don't need to know the value of the radius of the ball. And in the last part of the question, that height is 1.2 meter. The ball starts rolling from this point at the top of the incline. When the ball reaches to the bottom of the incline, what is the speed? What is the speed of the ball at the bottom of the incline? So we can use conservation of energy, okay? So this static frictional force just causing the object rotate. The energy is not lost during this motion. So energy is conserved, initial energy equal final energy. So initial kinetic energy is zero because start from rest, and it has only potential energy, mgh. And at the bottom of the incline, potential energy is zero. Potential energy is zero. It has only kinetic energy. So the object has a rotational motion and a translational motion. It has two kinetic energy here. There is two term for kinetic energy. This comes from the pure rotation. This pure translation. Okay, so the relation between omega and v, we know that. So when we insert omega in terms of v, we get this simple form. So we can write center of velocity of the ball, and it is equal to that one. When we insert the numbers, we get that velocity of the ball at the bottom of the incline is 4.1 meter over second. Okay, in the second problem, we have a vertical rod. We have a vertical rod, mass capital M, and length of the rod is d, and the rod can rotate about one end of the rod. Okay, about the point O, the rod can rotate. So we have another mass, small m, and this small m sliding through this frictionless surface. The height is h, and it slides down from through this frictionless surface, collide with the rod, and stick to the rod. So they move together after some height h double prime. Okay. And that angle is also theta. That angle is theta. So at this point, the maximum the system can reach, maximum to that height, and then swing about this point O. So in this problem, we are going to determine the theta, angle theta. So let's first determine H prime and H double prime. So this is the center of mass. Middle is the center of mass of the rod. When the rod swings angle theta, center of mass shifted by H prime. So H prime equal d over 2, 1 minus cosine theta. H double prime equal d times 1 minus cosine theta. So in this problem, angular momentum is conserved. We can write the conservation of angular momentum, initial angular momentum, equal to final angular momentum. And initial angular momentum is mvd sine 90. And final angular momentum is I omega. Why? Because there is only rotational motion here. So therefore, rotation about fixed point O. So therefore, we can write final angular momentum in this form, I times omega. So there is I zero is the rotational inertia of the rod, md square, rotational inertia of mass small m. So this is the velocity when the ball, when the m reaches the bottom of the incline, this is the velocity. We insert the velocity here, and rotational inertia of the rod about point O is 1 over 3 md square. So when we insert the values here, this is the angular velocity of the system after collision. Okay. So we determine angular velocity of the system. So after the collision, energy is conserved. Initial kinetic energy plus initial potential energy equal final kinetic energy plus final potential energy. Initial potential energy zero after the collision, and at that point, final kinetic energy zero because system momentarily stop at this point. So this is the initial kinetic energy 1/2 rotational inertia times omega square, and this is the final potential energy. Potential energy of rod, potential energy of small m. So after some algebra, we can get equation for theta, this one, this is cosine theta. When we, in order to determine theta, we have to take inverse cosine, and finally, this is the theta maximum angle that the system can reach that point. We study two lecture here, two important subject. One, rolling, torque, angular momentum, and rotation. These are very important subjects in physics, and these are also very important to understanding the universe and physical processes. We have done two examples for each subject. For another lecture, I hope that I can see you again. Thank you very much.